ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கே கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரவரியோமே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதாகிருதி நமோ நாராயணன். டுடேஸ் வர்சஸ் வர்ஸ் நம்பர் 9 ஆஃப் திருப்பாவை. தூமணி மாடத்து. தூமணி மாடத்து சுற்றும் விளக்கெரிய தூபம் கமலத்துயிலன மேல் கண் வளரும். மாமான் மகளே மணிக்கதவம் தாள் திறவாய். மாமீர் அவளை எழுப்பீரோ? உன் மகள்தான் ஊமையோ? அன்னிச்சவிடோ அனந்தலோ? ஏமப்பெருந்துயில் மந்திரப்பட்டாளோ? மாமாயன் மாதவன் வைகுந்தனன் என்ன நாமம் பலவும் நவின்றேலோ ரெம்பாவாய். ஹியர் தூமணி மாடத்து சுற்றும் விளக்கெரிய தூபம் கமல துயிலனை மேல் கண் வளரும். தே ஆர் அட்ரஸிங் ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் கோபிகாஸ். They are addressing and waking up the next Gopikai, and they are addressing, I mean, they are mentioning that Thoomani Madaththu Chuttrum, she is lying down on a cot and in a palatial building, which is like the lamps are lit all around, and with the gemstones inlaid impregnated onto the cot, and it's so beautiful, the mansion, and there is incense sticks, sandal paste, the smoke, sandal smoke, everything is coming, and it is so fragrant, and she is, and all around there is lamps are lit everywhere. It's a dazzling palatial building. Oh girl, maman mahale means the mama's daughter or the uncle's daughter, dear. And so Andal and Gopikas would like to have the sarira sambandham with this girl who is supposed to be the favorite of Kannan, and this lady is like a mukta jivatma, the acharyas say. So these gopis could see the enclosure, and within the enclosure the beautiful chambers, and they don't even know where is the lock, where is the door, where is the palace, because it is so beautifully beautifully organized, decorated, and the gemstones are laid on the wall, so they don't even know where the door is, and it is so nice and so glittering. So they are addressing mami avala elupiro, please, because they don't even know where the door is. They are looking through the window and they saw her mother go walking up and down. So they immediately address, mommy, please wake her up. She is not responding to our pleas. She is not listening, perhaps. Is she mute? Is she deaf? Or is she lazy? Or has she been cursed with long spell of sleep? Some because of some mantram? Or mamayan madhavan vaigundan enna naamam palavum navindrelor embavai, to wake her up from this kind of sleep, from this slumber, let us recite as a remedy the sahasranamam mamayan, the aacharya cheshtitam, the most wonderful lord, madhavan lakshmipati, vaigundan sri vaikunthanathan, like that very many names, divine names, we will recite, and please wake her up. So that's the essential meaning. The inner meaning is maman mahale, a very subtle thing is referred to here. There is a deha sambandham. They would like to have deha sambandham. Andal and Gopikas want to have deha sambandham with his favorite bhakti of Krishna. So that is why maman mahale. Aryashingar mentions Srimad in her Mukura Ishingar mentions that she is like the Maman Mahal Amman Mahal Amanga. So Amanga also means Alarmel Manga. Sri Mahalakshmi herself, she must be her daughter. All Prapannas are Sri Lakshmi Kumaras. Similarly, possibly they address her as Alamel Manga's daughter. So Aishinger nicely says the Gopikas picked up the lively girl from the door number 8 in the last verse, and they went to the next door, but they don't see a door number. They go to the next door and see there is 10. So this has to be 9, because between 8 and 10 the door has to be 9, but nothing was written on the wall or on the gate or on the door. There was no 9. Suddenly they realize that it is embossed in gold as 9. What a palace. Till last night this was just another small hut like all our homes. Today it's got huge ramparts, big hall. Entire hall is lit with most valuable gemstones, most beautiful golden lamps, and that are lit all around the house and on the fence. Inside a nicely decorated room, there is a big king-size cot on which even the bankrupt fellow can sleep peacefully. And it's so comforting, and soft foam bed is there. And our friend Krishna Bhaktai is sleeping so charmingly, beautifully, with ornaments worn all over her body. And the way she sleeps, it does not appear that she's sleeping. It appears as if she is wonderstruck with wide open eyes on something. Perhaps after talking to us last night, she, Kannan, would have come here and blessed her like he did for Kuchela, and replaced the whole house with this palatial building. Perhaps he has adorned her with all these kinds of jewelry which she is wearing. So Gopikas get great anandam looking at the blessing their friend got from Krishna. So their happiness could not be described in words. Maman Mahale. So Sriman Narayanan must have longed to have a daughter, and he must have created this most beautiful girl and became happy to see her sleep in such a nice bed palace made for her. Because Maman also means Amman, Amman Aripiran is how the Lord is addressed as. He is Sarva Sampat Sarudhan. So Maman, Ma Man Mahal, she is dear-eyed beautiful girl. Open the door. They say there is no response. We don't know where the door is. Everything looks spick and span. All appears same. We don't know where the wall is, where the door is, where the lock is. So in spite of all that, she does not respond and open. So they are addressing the mother. So they are saying, please wake her up. Is she deaf? Or is she caught in some sort of complacency after what she has done, what's to be done, and need not do any aradhanam anymore? And even if one is a krita krityan, means having surrendered to the Lord, and nitya karma has to be performed, naimittika karma has to be performed, as Bhagavad Prityatam, one should not stop doing sandhyavandanam. Similarly, mandira pattalo, has she been initiated into some mantras, thereby she has been misled to believe something unsampradayic, non-Vedic, or is that why she is not getting up? Which mantra? Maybe she has been initiated into some Devatantra mantra, or has someone misinterpreted the Tattvamasi and taught her? Is that why she is just lying down and enjoying her own self, thinking that mistakenly as Brahman? Should it not be understood in the right perspective, without any violating with the other Shruti Vakyam, that with the Sharira Shariri Bhavam, this means your soul's soul is Brahman. Conversely, Brahman is your soul's soul, and your soul is the body of Brahman. So it can be said that you yourself the Brahman. So Tattvamasi should be interpreted in the right way. According to Bhagavad Ramanuja, when the father says Tattvamasi, it means you belong to the Lord as His body, and He belongs to you as your innermost soul. If one thinks that he is Brahman, Srimad Ayyashinga says, it will only lead to Siddha Brahman, not Brahma, Brahman. It will violate and make many other Shruti Vakyams completely void. So anyway, digression. The mother says, okay, in that case, what shall we do for her if she is misled to believe other mantras? Not to worry. Mamayan, Madhavan, Vaikuntham, Govindan, Krishnan, Narayanan, Endre, Palanamam, utter these divine names. He is Vaikunthanathan. There is a place called Sri Vaikuntham. There are Nitya Suris, Mukta Jivatmas, Lotus Eyed Sriman Narayanan with Sri Devi, Bhudevi, Neela Devi. There is a Divya Mangala Vigraham for them. He is with his Mahalakshmi in his divine chest. Nothing is an illusion. All these are true. There are very many Jivatmas. There is Achetanam called Vaikuntham, Suddha Sattvam, Kalam, all that. Madhavan, Sriyapati, one who is ever with Sri, one who is seen by devotees as Sriyapati at all times in their eyes, in front of their eyes, with all the paraphernalia in his Divya Mangala Vigraham. That's why when we do Achamanam, we touch the eyes with Pavitra finger, uttering Madhavaya Namaha. He is Paramapavitran, Mamayan. He is the most mysterious one, most wonderful one, with Divya Cheshtitams, one who has Sakala Tattvams, Chit, Achit as his body, and himself being the inner soul, Antaryami in them. The totality of existence is like a wheel, God being the hub and the rim, the Jivas being the spokes connecting. They are inseparable but not identical with Him. The individual soul, while being the soul in relation to the Paramat body, constitutes the body of the Paramatma, who is none other than Sriman Narayana. He is Mamayan. Swami Srimad Aryashingar subtly brings the Visishtadvaita Sampradayic philosophy and the Vedantams in a simple, lucid commentary, and all such utterances of his divine names do not wake her up. Mommy, you know her nature. You know what for she gets up so that she can join us for Aradhanam to Krishna. She is the dear devotee of Kannan. She is the blessed one. Hence, please wake her up. So the essence of the Pasurams, the palace, the golden lamps, the beautiful cart, the bed, Anubhavam, is all the blessing from Kannan. It will all vanish once the dream is over. Meaning, after this birth, even if we are so blessed with lots of wealth, good position, good promotion, wonderful life, nice health, charm, good family, kulam, given by the Sriyapati, even then, this is not what we should be complacent with. It will all vanish in the next birth. In order to get the same manimandapam, the light everywhere, the paripurna anandam which never perishes, we need to do what needs to be done to get his deliverance, which is moksha. He is moksha pradhan as well as mukta prapyan. His moksha pradhan means the one who grants moksha. Mukta prapyan means where one, the jivatma attains after moksha. He is and attains as a mukta. If there is any merit, the credit goes to the wonderful commentary by Srimad Aryashingar. And the inner swapadesam here, the dupam kamala tuilanai mel kanvalarum. Dupam kamala, Uttamur Swami mentions that jnanam, anushtanam, vairagyam are referred to here in the swapadesam. The adhigari, the jivatma is resplendent with the nitya naimittika karmanushtanam and has vairagyam towards life's happenings, and that is what is referred to as dhubam kamala tuyiranemel kan valarum un mahal dan anantalo. Here mahal is referred to as the one who has done sharanagati, prapannan. Anantal is the garvam, satviha ahankaram, or the feeling a proud feeling of pride with that sattvika ahankara, because this uttama adhikari is aware of his akinchanyam, the helplessness, ananya gatitvam, having no other recourse except the Lord's lotus feet, and mahavishwasam, unconditional, complete, total faith in the Lord as sharanagata rakshaka achyutan, the one who never lets us down. So yema perunthuyil mandira pattalu, the mantiram is the akshtakshara mantram referred to here. Peyyumamuhil pol vanna mayaletri mayakka unmugam maya mandiram than kolo. And that is why perhaps she has been initiated with Ashtakshara mantram, and she is contemplating on that. Ma mayan madhavan vaihundan yendrendre namam palavum navindre. Ma mayan, here Perikaranai Swami mentions ma ayan, the big ayan, the big Gopa Kumaran, Nanda Gopa Kumaran, Kannan, ma ayan, this Gopa Kumaran who is always associated with Mahalakshmi. Or the ma sabdam also means the malolan, Madhavan. He is the Sriyapati. Ma ayan also means, ma means not, which is not a cowherd boy. He is not a simple cowherd boy. He is Mahavishnu. He is Sriman Narayana, Sarvaloka Sharanyan, Madhavan, Vaihundan, Enrendru Namam Palamum Navindre. So we need to remember him. We should never ever forget him. It is Emperuman Sankalpam to make us remember him or forget him. Matta Smriti. When the Sahasranamams of the Lords are recited, all anishtams are clear. So Yomam Nama Sagastrena Shroti Michati Pandava Soham Ekena Slokena Sutayeva Nashamshayaha. Have no doubt. One slokam alone is adequate for me, Krishna tells Arjuna. So we should always think that, we should always recite his divine names, the Nama Sankirtanam, Vishnu Sahasranama Stotram, which would grant all benefits to us. With that, we would conclude this verse. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Andal Thiruvadigale Sharanam Adiyen Namo Narayana.